After it, Allah says, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. So pray for your Lord. Meaning, Ya Rasulullah, perform salat for me and only me. Perform salat for your Lord as you are in a state of sincerity, and indeed he was the embodiment of sincerity, ikhlas. وَانْحَرْ. Before we get to the word انْحَرْ, realize this verse gives us more insight regarding the importance of salat. Why? Let me ask you a question, and I hope you're ready for this one. Zahra al-Batul alayha salam, is she great? Is Fatima al-Zahra great? Is she a great lady? Yes. Is she greater than the previous prophets, the prophets who preceded Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi? Of course. She is one of the greatest lights of God, one of the greatest creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala gives Rasulullah Fatima. She is al-Kawthar. Yes? But then he tells him what? Now, Ya Rasulullah, I want you to thank me. How do I thank you, Ya Allah? Thank me by doing salat, by performing prayer. Allahu Akbar. Prayer is the form of thankfulness that Allah wants Rasulullah to show him for giving him Fatima al-Zahra, salamullah alayha. Which tells you a lot about salah. Tells you a lot about the greatness of prayer. It's so great. Allah tells his prophet, now that I've given you Fatima, I want you to thank me through what? Through salat. Subhanallah. So the surah also contains a message for me and you pertaining to what? To salat and pertaining to morals. Because when one gives more importance, shows his salat more importance, more attention, what's going to happen? His salat will have a direct effect on him and on his conduct. The more attention we show to our prayers, the better we pray, the better we become in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hence you realize that the Zahra al-Batul salamullahi alayha would not only pray, wouldn't only preserve her prayers, but when she would pray, she would be completely focused with Allah azza wa jal.